Hi, this is Tim Francis, and a question I get asked all the time is how I was able to attend a 5-day, $20,000 training with none of my own money. Now, I encourage you to just for a moment think about what is your frame of reference. Thankfully for me, it wasn't a super huge stretch to think about raising $20,000 through investors and partnerships and such. Because in the past, I had purchased multiple real estate properties, $400,000 properties, $300,000+, $270,000 properties, and I'd done all of that without really using too much of my own money. So just under, the first thing that if you wanted to do just like I did and raise money, $20,000 or more to go do something, is think about your frame of reference. For me to raise $10 million to go purchase an apartment building or to start some huge project, for me, that's out of my frame of reference. But, there's a lot of people out there that for them raising $100 million is no big deal. Like, obviously they take it very seriously. However, it's not out of the realm of possibility. So I encourage you, whatever amount of money it is you're looking to raise or find partners for, just keep and think about that. What is your frame of reference going into it? Because, maybe it's easier than you think. Or maybe not. So just think about that. So the next thing I did was I had worked very diligently to host a number of business seminars in my city and also in another neighboring city. And so I had already kind of been strategically, positioned as a leader in the community as far as businesses. And it also really helped because I now had many contacts of other like-minded business people. And they saw how hard I worked and they saw, how much passion I put into things and they saw, how dedicated I was to really doing a fantastic job. And by showing them, it's one thing to tell someone that you're a hard worker and you're passionate and all the rest. It's another thing to show them. There's a saying, when everything is said and done, a lot more is said than done. And that's just the truth. So show people with your actions somehow that you're dedicated and they can trust you with their money. Now, the next thing is how I structured the deal. Now, a lot of that's confidential, so I can't go into it, into the specifics. Generally speaking, though, I arranged the deal with each of my partners in such a way that they had two options. Number one, they could just invest the money and sit back and receive their money as it came in. Or if they wanted to be really proactive, they would be able to make their money back way faster if they actually referred me clients. Now, even if they didn't refer me clients, it was still lucrative for them to be an investor and to just sit back. If they felt really eager, holy smokes, they could make their money back very quickly and have, quadruple digit returns on their cash. And one of my investors, in fact, did just that and is in under a year has almost doubled his money. So, it's a really fascinating thing when you set things up in such a way that it's not a loan, okay? It's not that you have to pay people back on a certain time schedule or anything. It's a partnership. And it's a partnership because these people believe in you and you believe in them. And by you taking the training, you become a resource to your investor. If they've got questions about whatever it is you're going to study, you can now have a really high level of education to help them. And furthermore, your partners, because the better, the more work that they feel like doing to bring you clients, the faster they get their money and the bigger their returns. And on your end of things, obviously, if you've got people that are working with you and have the same goals as you, guess what? You have to do less marketing yourself. It's a very, very smart way to set up a business deal so it's a win-win for everyone. So those are the general kind of guidelines around how I went about it. Aside from that, you probably want to just write out the deal specifics with each person into like a memorandum of understanding, just so that the details are clear. And then from there, celebrate the wins. When the money starts coming in, you can celebrate with your partners. I know I've had many great celebrations with my investors as we've been bringing in money, and I look forward to continuing that. This is Tim Francis, onwards and upwards.